My name's EdSky9, and today I'm going to be reacting to the 13th Clash Organization X111 or XIII montage. This was requested me quite a couple times, and I just figured since the person who asked me to react to it asked me before and I didn't get around to it, I figured why not? After all, I shouldn't disappoint a fan, right? So let's get this started. But a little reminder for all my fans, if you guys had a video that you wanted me to react to that I haven't reacted to yet, it's because I got a lot on my list and it's kind of hard to pick which. It's kind of hard to like try to catch up with that list, you know? Try to react to all the things that you want me to react to while trying to keep up with my normal life. So you guys need to bear with me. So without further ado, let's get this started. Cool. Yeah, well, it's supposed to be a Kingdom Hearts. Wait. This was supposed to be like a Kingdom Hearts type of video, right? Cool. Never really played Kingdom Hearts myself, but it does look like a pretty cool game. There's gonna be a new game for this this year, right? Maybe I'll buy it. Yeah, I like how Sora's main weapon is a key. I suppose that key helps him unlock his destiny. I'm sorry. I had to. Not bad. But what exactly am I supposed to be watching? It's just a compilation of all the boss fights, I think. This game is pretty cool looking, though. Why have I not played this game any sooner? I know what I'm gonna add to my list. Wait a minute, do all of his opponents have keys? What is up with these keys anyhow? I don't really know that whole concept. The only thing that I know of is that Sora, Donald, and Goofy have to try to save the world or something. And apparently in the next game, there's going to be a lot more characters, including like guys from Marvel movies, I think. And Pixar. I swear, I think Sora fought that guy earlier before. Now I'm really confused. I know I saw Sora fight this person before. Is this just like repeated battles? Not really. I don't play cards. Exactly what kind of game are you at? I appreciate the fact that they're not doing any action so that I can make a joke, but okay, there we go. Wow, I think he had a bit of a... He won the game. I guess you could say that he had an ace up his sleeve, huh? If I see a joke, I'm gonna take the opportunity to say it, alright? Don't judge me. Wow, what a groundbreaking performance. Sorry about that, I was interrupted, but we could continue the video. We can continue the video now. I said we can continue the video now. This is actually fun to watch, it's cool. Makes me realize how good of a game Kingdom Hearts is, so I'm definitely gonna buy the new one that's gonna be coming out this year. This has got to be one of the only fights where a person is fighting another guy off of a glass window. Oh my god. You know, that person that Sora's fighting is probably worried about how the fight's gonna end. After all, they're beside themselves. You guys are probably gonna be hearing a lot more jokes in the future of this video. I'm just saying right now. So if you guys don't want to hear any jokes, just click off the video immediately. Whoa! Stranger danger! 99? What the heck is that supposed to mean? Is that the amount of time hit points that Sora has? Like, if he's attacked, then he's gonna... Even though Sora's always pinned down by a strong enemy, he's a cut above the rest. Not bad, not bad. Was that code? So apparently Sora is fighting some dude in a white blank plane of existence. Just fighting in nothingness. Well, it wouldn't be the first time for any heroes in any game, so why the heck not? If you guys think that I'm not enjoying this, I'm not. That's not true. I actually think this is pretty cool. It's actually really entertaining to watch. Man, the guy that Sora's fighting is on fire right now. Well, actually, Sora is, because he's getting attacked. Oh, man. That opponent of Sora's is shockingly powerful. And this game looks like it's got a lot of mechanics. Cool. You know, it's kind of weird. Like, how many kinds of guys, like, how many heroes uses a key as a weapon? It just occurred to me. Because now that I think about it, if you guys ever watched Red vs. Blue from Ruby, I mean, Rooster Teeth, sorry. If you guys ever watched that show, there's a character named Tucker. He has a turquoise armor. He's like the perverted character, but he's like one of my favorite characters. He's really funny, he's cool, and for some reason, he was lucky enough to find this, what are those swords called? The ones that you get in Halo, the light up, that's basically like a lightsaber? I forgot what they're called. Apparently it turns out that the sword is not just a sword, but it also functions as a key in some ways. Of course, it was kind of a joke when the sword was first introduced, but the whole it being a key thing kind of came back after a while. If you guys haven't watched the show, I suggest that you do. It's one of my favorite web series that ever, and it's so hilarious. And if you guys are into Halo, then that's another reason why you should watch it, because it's pretty cool. Hey now, what's going on? My screen was just glitching for a sec. I know that's just a part of the video, but that's just a joke. Oh my god, is that the same guy with the... Yeah, that's gotta be the same guy who had the cards, isn't it? XO... The cards had X's and O's on them. I gotta say though, a villain whose theme is cards, quite the gamble. Oh man, I knew I was gonna have another joke in the end. I was just thinking, I was hoping I was gonna make another joke, and I did. Is that a shadow version of Sora? Okay, I can't help but think of how cliche that is. Because we've had, like, so many different heroes who have that inner darkness, or just a dark version of themselves. Like, we got Ichigo from Bleach, who has that hollow version of him. We got Spyro becoming Dark Spyro, trying to fight the evil urges in him. And we got... we just got so many different types of protagonists who've got that inner darkness in them. I mean, it's cool and all, but it's kind of cliche. Oh, that's cool. Ooh! Man, they sure are fast. Sora's got some reaction speed, I can tell you that. I can notice that much. Oh man, I could just like imagine a fight between Sora and someone else in a death battle in Screw Attack. I love that channel. Death battle is like one of the coolest things to watch. And honestly, it's I kind of wonder why they don't have Sora for like death battles. Screw Attack, if any of you guys who from Screw Attack are watching, you gotta do that. That'd be kind of cool. Like, imagine, like, oh, it's done. But, yeah, like I said, imagine, like, a fight between Sora and some other guy who uses a key, like, a certain turquoise dude. And, like, I just would love to see that kind of fight. That'd be kind of cool. Alright, well, that's it for the video. I kind of liked it. It was cool, and it was actually a great thing to watch, because then I had so many material. Hopefully, you guys, any of you guys who stayed through the video to watch me and me saying my jokes, congratulations to you who managed to survive. So, thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, please click that like button. Subscribe if you want to watch more of my videos, and I'll see you all next time. Ciao, goodbye, adios. And have a good day.
Thank you.